Hi folks, my name is Aaron Powell and I'm a Principal Cloud Advocate here at Microsoft. In this video, we're going to create some files and folders, as well as look at how we can do error handling. We'll start by creating a new folder where we'll output the files that are the result of our SOAR report analysis data that we're generating. And to do this, we're going to need to check if that file exists or not. And if it does exist, well, we might want to clean it up. Otherwise, we're going to create it. And we don't want to create a directory that already exists. And we don't want to accidentally override an existing output. To make a new directory, we're going to use the mkdir, or short for make directory function, and it's going to return us a promise. So it's still going to be asynchronous. So we're going to extract out a couple of paths, which are the sales directory. So that's where we're going to look for all the files, and then the totals directory. So that's going to be in a folder called sales totals, which will sit alongside. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is call await fs.makedir, and that's just going to create the directory on disk. But what if the folder does exist? Well, make directory is going to throw an error that you can handle with a normal try catch. And this is actually the recommended approach. Rather than testing to see if the folder already exists on disk, you catch the exception. This helps reduce race conditions in Node because Node is designed to be asynchronous. So the time between testing a folder exists and then trying to create it, well, another part of your application might have also created it. So it is better practice to just try and catch the exception and then gracefully handle any potential errors. So we just wrap that in a try catch. And this is a little bit simplistic. We're not catching the various different errors. We're just going to say, well, if it did raise an error, we're just going to assume that's because the folder already existed, and then we'll carry on in our application. So you might consider doing something a little bit more robust in your own application, but it's now time to start creating a file where we can put the sales analysis. And for that, we're going to use the write file method. So the way the write file works is that we provide it with the path to a file that we want to generate, and then the contents of that file. And again, it's asynchronous, so we're just going to wait on it. And then I'm just going to do console.log and just indicate that our application is completed. We're also using the path.join method here to make sure that we create the path correctly with the correct file system path separator. And we're just going to put an empty string here. We haven't built our report yet. By default, write file will open the file in an append mode, meaning if it already exists, we'll just add to that file. Now, this isn't ideal for the way that our report's going to generate. We want to replace the report every time. So we probably want to remove any existing reports that are there. To remove a file in Node, we use an unlink method. Again, we'll wrap this in a try catch. Just in case the file doesn't exist on disk, then we won't need to unlink it, and we don't want our application to crash because it wasn't able to remove a file that doesn't already exist. So here we go. We've added our try catch with the unlink in it, and if it catches, it just says that it's failed to remove. And again, this is overly simplistic in the way that we're doing our error handling. You might want to actually provide the error message or log that somewhere. But we're almost there. We've stubbed out the way that we're going to be writing our files using the Node.js modules. In the next video, we're going to create that file and actually write the file contents properly to disk. See you next time.